aren't we? So stand up. We're going to start with the tree pose because it's fun and because it's easy and because I like it. So you bring the sole of the right foot to the inside of the left thigh, perhaps. You can either bring the hands together in prayer pose in front of you or out like that or up above you like that. Whatever works for you with the hands is okay. If the foot thing is all right and you want a little more, you can take the right foot up as in a half lotus. And by pushing the knee down, the foot will stay in place, pushing it down and back. Very gracefully come down. Let's do the other side. There's all sorts of variations on this basic posture, but they're all pretty much the same. Just to work on balance, centering yourself. Bring the hood down. Get the feet about hip distance apart, not much wider. Interlock the hands behind you and come all the way forward into a forward bend. Relax your neck. If you can roll the weight toward the balls of the feet, you'll get a little more stretch in the calves and back of the knees. But if that's too much, don't do that. Bring the hands down, just hang down. Step the feet a little bit wider. Keep the left hand on the floor, raise the right arm up in the air, roll the chest open, look up. If you want a little more twist, you can walk the left hand over towards the right foot a little more. And bring the hand down to the other side. Okay, bring the hand down. Roll all the way up. Step or jump the feet together. Whee! Very energetic. Bring the hands like so. Prayer pose, that is. Inhale the arms up. Drop the head back. If you want to arch back, you're premature, but go ahead. And then exhale and come all the way forward. Flatten the hands on the floor, lift the head up, inhale, jump or step back. Stay there in the top of the push-up, don't come down yet, Sheila. Where are you going? One hand? Later. Slowly come down toward the floor. When you get close, arch up into the upward facing dog. Make sure the legs are straight. If you can get them off the floor, that's even better. Arms are straight. Always try and pull the shoulders back and down if you can, pushing the chest forward, which will open up your chest and your upper back. Just don't tell them I give you anything you want. next time you exhale, push back into the downward facing dog. Walk the feet in a little toward the hands. Well, loosen up. You guys were in good shape before. Must have had some chili for lunch. And raise the right leg up in the air. Push the left heel down toward the floor. Just for fun, bend the right leg and kind of drop it behind you. You can extend the heel or toe, whatever you like. Keep the arms straight, though. Try to keep the shoulders pretty much level to one another. And then take the foot and swing it up to the hands into a crescent pose. Straighten the back leg, stay on the ball of the back foot. Keep the arms as straight as you can. Keep the breath moving through the nose. Don't hold your breath at all. And bring the hands down to the floor. Step the foot back. Come on down. Arch up, up dog. And exhale and push back, down dog. Raise the left leg up in the air. Again, bend the leg, drop it back behind you. And swing it up. Crescent pose. No need asking where I've been, just ask me where I'm going. I won't be a stranger. If it's too difficult to straighten the back leg, you can bend it a little bit, but try to straighten it at least. What happens if you slide the back foot a little further? Keep going. Nothing is impossible. Bring the hands down. Step the foot back. Come down. And up, up dog. And push back, down dog. Stay here, keep the breath moving, sink the chest so your upper back and shoulders get a nice stretch. And as light as you can, jump the feet up to the hands. You can always step them if jumping is not going to happen. Roll all the way up, stretch up and arch back. Exhale, come all the way forward. From here, bring the arms up in the air, bend the legs into a chair pose. The dancing chair. Finally, a little life. I thought Patrick's the only one that's alive. And bring the hands to the floor, straighten the legs. And just hang there for a moment. Take a few deep breaths. We'll be back for more warm-up. Yoga style on Inhale.
Inhale only on Oxygen Media.
Yes. Yes. We're back. Roll all the way up. Stretch up. Arch back. More warm-up for you. Exhale. Come all the way forward. This may be burnout rather than warm up. Lift the head, jump back. Come down slow. That's the only thing slow. Inhale and arch up. Push back, exhaling. Okay, raise the right arm up in the air, turn to the side, the one-armed incline. You're beginning to hate this, I'm sure.
I like it.
We're gonna hold it till I feel it. I haven't felt it in many years. All right, come down, do a push-up. Do the other side. Fantastic. Bring the hand down. Come all the way down. Arch up. Upward dog. And push back. Down dog. Raise the right leg up in the air. Now, this may work, it may not, but we'll just try it and see what happens. Keep the right leg up in the air. See if you can raise the left hand off the floor, in front of you or out to the side or behind your back. If you fall, that's not unusual. Just try it again. It takes a little strength and a lot of balance. And bring it all down before somebody gets hurt. Let's try the other side. Left leg up in the air. Right hand off the floor this time. Whatever works best for you. In front, behind you. Different people like it different ways. But everybody likes it to this music. All right, bring it all down. Before your shoulders explode, you better jump the feet up to the hands. Roll all the way up, stretch up. Exhale, come forward. Hands are down, head is up, jump back or step back. Come down. Arch up, up dog. And push back, down dog. Raise the right leg up in the air. Swing the foot up into a crescent pose. From here, turn the back foot flat down. Turn to the side. Warrior. Sink down into it with the right leg.
Chapter 7, verses 16 and 17. Yes, sir. They shall hunger no more.
Crank
it. Neither shall they thirst anymore. Preach, preach up. For God shall wipe away. Yes, sir. Every tear from their eyes. Yes, sir.
All right, slide the left hand down the back leg. Reach back with the right arm. The more you roll, the right ribs and shoulder open, the better the stretch. Really extend with the right fingertips. See if you can turn the palm down toward the floor. At the same time, bend the right leg a little bit if you possibly can. And bring the right hand down to the floor, flat down to the inside or outside of the front foot. Whichever works better for you. Left arm straight up in the air, or if you can, straight over your head is also good. But keep rolling the left ribs open. keeping the right leg bent, come back up into a warrior pose. That'll teach you to volunteer. Now from here, bring the right hand down, reach underneath the front leg, grab the left hand or wrist behind your back if you can. If you can't, don't worry about it. You can bring the right hand to the floor and just reach behind you with the left hand.
Very serious tonight.
Okay, bring the hands down. Step the foot back. Come down. Shake it out. Come down. Arch up. And push back. Down dog. Left leg up in the air. Swing the foot up. Crescent pose first. Turn the back foot flat down, turn to the side, warrior. Slide the right hand down the back leg. Reach back. Again, roll the shoulder open. Look up if you can. Most of the weight obviously is on the back foot, but you want to keep bending the front leg just to make it a little more intense if possible. And bring the left hand down to the floor. Flat down if you can. Right arm straight up in the air or straight over your head. Come back up, warrior. Keep smiling no matter what your thigh feels like. Take the left hand and reach underneath the left leg. Grab the right hand behind you. Again, roll the chest open as much as you can. And bring the hands down, step the foot back, sink down, arch up, push back, down dog, jump both feet up to the hands and just hang down with the legs straight, roll the weight toward the balls of the feet. We'll be right back.
You're watching Oxygen Media.
And we're back. So roll all the way up, stretch up. Whoa. Oh, mercy, mercy me. Exhale and come all the way forward. Lift the head, jump or step back. Stay up in the top of the push-up for a moment. And this time when you come down, make it so slow as to be ridiculous. Keep the body straight. Don't let the butt sag down unless it's age related. Very slow. Too late, we lost a few. And then arch up, upward dog. And push back, down. Raise the right leg up in the air. Never get tired of saying that one. Although you may be tired of doing it. Swing the foot up. Turn the back foot down. We're going to do a different kind of lunge. just bring the hands down to the floor. If you can reach underneath the right leg and grab the right ankle with the right hand, the outside, and grab the inside with the left, and just come way down. Sink down into it as deep as you can. Keep the back foot flat down, though. If it's too hard on your knee, you can stay on the ball of the back foot. That makes it easier. Now, if you're very flexible, you can tuck your head under the calf like this, although you may have to be hosed down to get out of it. And then bring the hands flat, step the foot back, and come down. Arch up, upward dog, we all right? Push back, down dog. Yeah. Left leg up in the air. Swing it up. Other side, same thing. Turn the back foot down first. Grab the outside of the left ankle with the left hand, inside of the left ankle with the right hand. If you can bring the forearms down, that's great. If you can tuck the head under the leg, great. But any variation on the basic theme is good, as long as you're feeling a deep stretch in the hip, thigh. Come down and arch up. And push back down. Jump the feet up to the hands. Slowly without the chair pose. So bring the arms up. Bend the legs. What happened to the dancing? Bring the hands down, straighten the legs. Sit down on the floor. Turn to the side. We'll try this. If it works, it works. If it doesn't, it doesn't. Here's what you do. You bring the hands about a foot behind you like so. Push the feet flat, hips up, chest up, head back. Reverse slant pose. Now, if that's too much for you, you can bend the legs and go like that. That makes it a little easier. Walking the feet in a little closer to the butt. And then sit down. You have to turn the other way on your mat. Bring the hands down. Jump the feet back. And arch up, up dog, it almost worked. And push back, downward dog. Right leg up in the air.
The devil's on his way.
Swing the foot up. Crescent pose, except this time, instead of having the arms up like that, interlock them behind you. And pull the shoulders back, pushing the chest forward. If you can drop the head back at the same time. Now bring the arms up. Now slowly lean out over the front leg and come up into a balanced pose. Sink the chest if you can while raising the leg. You start to lose it and you have to bring the hands down, it's okay, just start over. And bring the hands to the floor and foot to the floor. So feet are together. roll all the way up, stretch up. You want to arch back, go ahead. And exhale, come all the way forward. Lift the head, jump backward, step back. Come on down. And arch up, up dog. Push back down. Left leg up in the air. Yeah, man. Swing the foot up. Again, the mutated crescent pose. The hands are behind you, interlocked, pulling the shoulders back, chest forward. If you can drop the head back, great. Bring the arms up, straight up. Slowly lean out. Come on up into the balance pose. Bring it all down. Foot down, hands down. All the way up. Stretch up. If you can arch back, good for you. Exhale, come all the way forward. Now you're starting to come alive. Lift the head, jump back or step back. No time to rest. Come all the way down. Arch up. Push back. Down, down. Jump the feet up to the hands. Jump them right back. Don't lose it. Come on down, hurry. Arch up. Push back. Down dog. Ow. Yeah, man, jump the feet to the hands. Roll up. Stretch up and arch back if you can. And exhale and come all the way forward. Just hang here. Very good job. That's very beautiful, my friend. Relax your neck. Stay here. Stay tuned. We'll be back very soon. On inhale.
Inhale, we'll be back in a moment.
And we're back. How about you? So bring the left leg straight out in front of you. You can bend the right leg, bring the sole of the right foot to the inside of the left thigh. Or if you want to get more exotic, you can pull it up into a half lotus like that, which is very useful for cutting off the circulation of the left leg. Stay here, breathe. Before you explode, it's time to go over to one side. Keep the left leg straight and the right leg straight, but go over the left leg, extending the left heel as much as you can. Walk yourself over, come down. There's a book called the Yoga Sutras by Patanjali, which is one of the books yoga, one of the texts yoga is based on. And the very first sutra, which is considered to be the most important one, is called, or it actually says in Sanskrit, Yogas Chitta Vritti Nirodha, which means yoga is the stilling of the modifications of the mind. So that means a quiet mind. So if you can do this and have very few thoughts or very deep silence, even underneath the thoughts, then you're doing yoga. If you're just sitting there and daydreaming and thinking about what you're gonna do later or what you're gonna eat, then you're just doing gymnastics. Looks like yoga from the outside, but it's not yoga. So see if you can bring that awareness into it. And if you can do that, you can do it in any condition. Doesn't matter if it's quiet on the outside or if there's music playing. It's an inner experience, not an external. But there is an external experience we need to change. The other side. Come on over to it. Keep the mind still. Another definition of yoga is when the mind and the breath and the body are all in unison. So you're completely present here in this moment, breathing and feeling every sensation. It's not about doing the pose perfectly. There's people in the circus that can do it better than anyone else. It's the mentality. It's the awareness, really. The transcendence of the mentality. And slowly come up. Bring the legs straight out in front of you. Reach out and grab if you can. Come all the way down. We're gonna be here a little while. Just drop the head down. Same thing. Relax the body. See if you can sink into that awareness below the thoughts. So you're aware of the body and you're aware of the thoughts, but you're also aware of that consciousness, that witness that's aware of both. Slow down the breathing, the mind will follow. So make long, deep breaths your practice in a pose like this.
Thank you.
little bit more. Keep the breath moving. Doesn't look like much from the outside, but on the inside, it's happening. And very slowly, start to roll up. Lie flat on your back. We'll be back very soon for more.
You're watching Inhale.
And we're back. Hopefully you're lying down flat on your back with your eyes closed. Body is completely open. Just let it melt into the floor. The floor will support you. Just completely let go. See if you can feel the muscles and tissues just melting away from the bones into the floor. Thoughts arise in this relaxation, it's okay. But be aware of the gap in between each thought. As you practice more yoga, more meditation, the gaps between thoughts get longer. And peace becomes your presiding, your permanent, actually, state. Underneath whatever chaos is happening on the surface, underneath there's a deep, vast peace. And if you can access it for this one moment, it's enough. Start to bring your awareness back a little bit. Keep the eyes closed. And just pull the right knee into the chest very slowly. Don't rush. And gently drop it over the straight left leg, pushing the right shoulder down so you're just unwinding your back into a gentle twist. We're not going to stay here long, just long enough. Unwind, and do the other side. Straighten the right leg, bend the left. Pull it toward the chest. And just let it fall gently over the straight leg. Push the left shoulder and shoulder blade down. Take a deep breath or two. Again, slowly unwind. Then roll to the side with both legs bent. And bring yourself up into a sitting position. Just comfortable, relaxed. As always, bring yourself fully into this moment as you can. See if you can sense or feel the inner energy in your body, the life force actually moving through your form. It has a kind of electrical, vibratory, tickly, blissful sensation.